What I am holding is a large chunk of the gemstone peridot matrix, as peridot is simply the name for gem-grade olivine crystals. Olivine is fairly widespread in the Earth's mantle, but far less so in the crust. Yet, according to some estimates, between 90 to 95% of all the world's gem peridot comes from a single square kilometer, or 0.386 square mile patch of land. This patch of land is located on a feature in the San Carlos Apache Reservation in Arizona, appropriately known as Peridot Mesa. Peridot Mesa was the site of the last volcanic eruption in a now extinct volcanic field, which partially occurred with a bang 580,000 years ago. This volcanic field is known as the San Carlos Volcanic Field, which for a brief period of time around 2 million years ago was one of 7 active volcanoes in the state. Yet, of the recent volcanic fields that exist entirely within Arizona, the San Carlos Volcanic Field is by far the smallest. The San Carlos Volcanic Field is located in east-central Arizona, where it is approximately 100 miles east of the city of Phoenix. This volcanic field, which was active between 5 million and 580,000 years ago, produced a series of 20 vents and associated lava flows spread out over an area of approximately 123 square miles. While many of these vents are separated from one another, they all neatly occur in a 35-mile-wide and 18-mile-long rectangle. These vents consist of spatter cones, small-volume shield volcanoes, cinder cones, and tuff rings, with each resulting landform indicating the nature of the eruption which formed it. This volcanic field exists due to a weak point in the crust related to a more than 1-billion-year-old subduction zone. As 1.7 billion years ago, a large subduction zone existed across what is now New Mexico and eastern Arizona. Eventually, this subduction zone suddenly shifted southwards, leaving large amounts of hydrous mineral-rich oceanic crust in the upper mantle and lower crust. This lowered the temperature which rock can melt at, causing this region to act as a permanent weak spot in the crust known as the Jemez Lineament. This formed a number of geologically recent volcanic fields with fairly long lifespans, including the San Carlos Volcanic Field beginning 5 million years ago. As low silica basaltic magma intruded into the crust, it generated a series of earthquakes along the way that got shallower and shallower. Eventually reaching shallow depths, the magma interacted with overlying groundwater. This caused the water to flash to steam, build in pressure, and explode upwards in a powerful explosive eruption which carved out a circular 2,600-foot-wide tuff ring crater. From this vent subsequently erupted basaltic lava which covered much of the crater bottom, eventually spilling over to form a 2-mile-long lava flow which cooled as a black color. The next eruption was longer duration and occurred 10,000 years later, forming a 240-foot-high low prominent shield volcano and an eruption which probably looked fairly similar to the 2021 eruption of the Fagradalsfjall volcano in Iceland. With long pauses in between distinct eruptions, more vents erupted in the vicinity, forming both spatter cones through mainly effusive eruptions and cinder cones through moderately explosive eruptions which created tall lava fountains and up to 2-mile-high ash plumes. As time progressed, vents in the field shifted to the west, eventually creating a scattered assortment of hard basalt and basanite capping lava flows. Since the lava was harder than the underlying rock, it protected it from erosion, allowing small plateaus and mesas to form. Then, 580,000 years ago, a large intrusion of magma began from the upper mantle. While in the mantle, it carried large chunks of existing olivine crystals with it as this high gas content intrusion rapidly raced upwards. Eventually reaching the surface, a powerful explosive eruption occurred, generating a 10-mile-high ash-rich eruption column. Part of this column collapsed downwards and created pyroclastic flows which scorched the landscape in all directions in about a 1.5-mile radius. Low-viscosity phonotephrite lava then erupted from a vent on the northeast section of the newly formed 2,700-foot-wide and 200-foot-deep tuff ring, going undercover an area of 4 square miles in a few weeks. This lava and the earlier explosions emplaced large amounts of olivine, some of which were gem-grade as xenoliths in the lava, where they are mined today as peridot crystals. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank Nick Tavenier for becoming a new patron on this channel's Patreon page.